I'm Miss Champagne B. We're here for a little bit of a wine tasting from a local winery here in Columbus. So wine, you know, last time we talked, we were talking about gin. I'm still doing my gin exploration. I'm almost coming to an end. I know I told you guys we were going to make some gin, and we are. But it's taking a while to get these juniper berries in. Like, there's a lot of shortages happening. Chicken shortage, the Ramune shortage, like there's a lot of shortages happening right now. So there's that. But we will make our own gin. It's coming. Don't lose faith. Don't lose hope. Also, if you are on YouTube, please, please, please subscribe to me. Help me hit those thousand subscribers. I just need to get 598 more followers. So please, please, please help. Subscribe, help a sister out. Also follow me on Instagram. Like, I post cool stuff. You know, I got a little variety. Love and cocktails, love comedy and cocktails. Like, I keep you entertained sometimes. So, again, we're talking about wine today. Wine, which is a cool fact to know about wine. French wine. French wines are named after regions in France. So, my name, Champagne, is a region in France that produces a certain type of wine, which is the wine that you guys are most, you know, familiar with when it comes to champagne, a little bit of bubbly. I probably got lipstick on my face. If I do, I apologize. I try to look sexy. It's hard to look sexy in a mask. So if I look like a clown, mind your business, okay? I'm practicing for Halloween. So this comes from a winery here in Columbus called Camelot Cellars. There you go. I don't know if you guys have had the pleasure of going, but if you're here in Columbus, Ohio, it's located on South 18th and Oak Street. And it's kind of that new, like the Old Town East, kind of like that area over there. It's a nice, small, trendy place. They have a live music playing on Fridays and Saturdays. It's really invitation only or reservation only. So you can't just show up and be there. You gotta put your reservation in there. They have live music and they have very good cuisines. Like, it's like a trendy urban soul food, if I had to explain how it tastes. Right now they're undergoing a little bit of a change in their menu, and it looks very promising. So definitely check them out if you haven't had a chance. A black owned restaurant. So, you know, if you want to go and support, it's great. They make a lot of sweet wines, like specialty sweet fruit wines. They do have some reds. They have some nice reds. They definitely have some whites, but the sweet fruit wines is what they really excel in. So we're talking about things like blueberry Pinot Noir, dragon fruit Shiraz, Moscato, of course, a hard pink lemonade, a Cab Franc. They just have so many different types of wine. So go there, get your little sample tasting, $1, and just enjoy the vibe. They have little events going on as well, and it's a great place to kind of rent out if you want to do bridal events or parties and whatnot. So today, one of the drinks that we're trying that I love, which is the fruit wine, it is called the Hard Black Cherry Lemonade. Hard Black Cherry Lemonade. Ooh, right? So today, we're not just going to drink wine. We're also going to learn a cool skill. So keep watching. This right here, this is what we're going to use to open one of these. Some of you guys have this in your house, and you don't know what the fuck it is. You can get these for like 50 cents at the dollar store. These go by a couple of different names. A wine key, a wine service, a bottle opener, service, whatever. These are used to pop tops off of beer bottles and to pull out corks from your wine. Now, some of you guys don't know how to do it. You try it. You've done peeled off the cork, and now it's inside the wine, and nobody wants to drink corky wine. Get it? Corky, not quirky. Corky. If you don't know how to use this, we are going to learn today. I might not have the proper way to use it, but it works. I feel like it's pretty proper. All right, so right here we have the opening. Some of you fellas out there, y'all need to watch this because you are interested in a lady who is way above your pay grade. You know it. I know it. It is what it is. And you're trying to knock her socks off. But here's the thing. She's a wine snob, and you don't know a dadblame thing about wine. Well, you are in for a treat, my guy, because I'm going to show you a little something about wine. I, too, believe in love, and I want you to get the woman of your dreams by making you a little bit smarter about wine. So, first things first. Some wines, you screw off the cap. We're corking this baby. Right here, this is a little, there's a little tab right there. If you're ever curious of how to get your wine off, that's a tab. You pull that tab, pops that off. Now it makes that little opening right there, will let you know the seal has been broken. On the flip side, if you're in a store and you see this, I don't know if you really want to buy that. I don't know. It's been tampered with, my guy. All right. So then what I just do, I just pull it up from the top. Some people try to get a little fancier and use the little knife on the wine key. Oh, yes. The wine key does have a knife. So you could get stabby if you need to. This is, people take this and they'll go around the neck. Some, not all wines have that tab. So thank you, Camelot Cellars, for doing that. Some wines, they just want you to use magic to open it. And if that's the case, you can take this, put it around the neck, and kind of trace it around to make that tear around it, and you can pull up the top. So we're going to pull down the knife because I don't really need to lose a finger. I already have some issues going on with this finger, but I still need it. We're going to go to this top. This over here, this is going to be important, but this is also, if you have a bottle top right here, you can take it, boom, pop it off, bam, pop it, pew, pew. Amazing, right? And then finally, you have the star of the show, the corkscrew, which has murdered a lot of people in movies. But the only thing we're murdering tonight is this bottle of wine. And maybe that not that much because I am on my fitness. Boop. There you go. The smooth cork. Yes. Treat that cork so well. Right? Have your pointy screw, corkscrew. Boop, boop, boop. And this is where it's going to get a little fun. So I take mine, I take the pointy, and I kind of poke it in the middle because I want to keep it as center as I can, because the more centered it is, the more even it will be so that you have a better chance of pulling out the whole entire cork without it breaking up inside your bottle. So once I put the pressure there, I start to turn it. And just like a screw, it's going to screw down. And as you see, it's turning. I'm turning it. You know, lefty-loosey, righty-tighty. Now, this is when this son of a bitch come to play. So I push it down like this, and I fold it under. I want tension in it. I want it to grip, and I want tension. Some are really ghetto, and you want them, they might come down if you pull too hard, and they'll scrape the hell out your finger. How I kind of avoid that, sometimes I'll take my finger and support it right here to kind of keep it tighter. If I find that it's harder for me to pull it out, I know it's not deep enough, and I want to go deep. Tighten it up so that the metal part rests well on the glass part, not the cork part. It has to be on the glass. Let me see if I can show you guys. If you can see, it has to be on the glass part, because if you put it over the cork part, you're going to tear the cork. And then you're going to exert a lot of non-necessary activity, you guys. Don't do that. Push it back a little bit. And then we're going to push up with a nice amount of pressure. See how I pushed up? Just push it up. Push it up. Did you hear it? Look at that. Look at that. Nothing but cork, baby. Look at that. I had a little itch here because I fucked up. You know, I told you guys what not to do when I did it. But I recognized what I did and I pulled it back, so there's not cork in there. But it could have gone horribly awry, right? Right. Like, it's very easy. And sometimes they have to be broken in. And sometimes you just got to keep practicing and get till you get it right. Once I got it right, you couldn't tell me nothing. So keep practicing. We're going to put that back. So now we have our hard black cherry lemonade, which is up from Camelot Cellars. Ooh. It smells kind of like almost like a cherry soda, something like that. Ooh, yeah, you definitely get that cherry aroma. Okay. It's light. So when you pour your wine, you know, pour it on the side of your glass. There you go. Yeah, let that pour. Now, some of you guys like to pour a whole bunch of wine all the way up to here. You guys are some freaking alcoholics, okay? You don't need that much wine. I mean, unless you got kids, then yes, you do need a lot of wine. But honestly, technically, you're only supposed to have one serving of wine is 5 ounces. In a bottle, I think it's like 5 to 6 servings of wine in a bottle, maybe. So you're not supposed to pour it all the way up here. You're supposed to really just pour 5 ounces. But hey, you paid for it. Who am I to judge? Once you put it in, a good thing you may want to try doing for your wine, sometimes people move it around, swirl it to allow it to aerate, let the air hit it so that its true smell and scent can come out. Yes, that cherry, that fragrance. Oh my gosh. Put your nose in it. Oh yeah. Not fizzy at all. Sweet. You taste the cherry. You taste the cherry really well. It's light. It's almost like if I had to, it's like a Mike's hard lemonade. If Mike made a hard lemonade, it wouldn't be as hard as his lemonade. It's kind of like a bougie hard. Like, ooh. Like, ooh, like, Now, as you guys know, I'm not going to drink this whole bottle of wine tonight. I just don't want my wine to be open, so open like this, because it loses its, it starts to lose its taste. The profile starts to go a little flat. You don't want your wine to go flat. So I recommend you, some people can take their cork, turn it upside down, and push it back in there, but that only works if the cork is kind of inverted, a little bit smaller at the bottom. This is not that. And again, I hurt my finger, so I can't force anything down. But this right here is called it's for resealing your wine. It's by Kappa Bunga. This is cute. It says, one says pour, drink, repeat. One says wino, wino, wine. Oh, that's cute. So we remove the existing cap and cork. Reseal with Kappa Bunga. Make sure to push down fully over bottleneck. Do not use on champagne, Prosecco, Moscato, or any other wine with bottles. No bottles here, so we're good to go. The reason why you don't want to use these for wines with bottles is because they kind of push that pressure down in it. When wines that have bubbles have a top on it, it pops off. Like the pressure underneath it, because it's sealed so tight, it the force builds up overnight. And then it just pops open. And the crazy part is like, you're not here. Wine. Ooh. Put that on top. And it's silicone. And there we go. And here's the ultimate test. Woo! I recommend this hard black cherry lemonade. Because some of you guys are like, all right, well, who would you recommend it to? The cherry is overpowering. The lemonade does not. I don't taste so much lemonade in it. I would have liked for it to be a little more present, but it tastes very good. It tastes very good. So you're like, should I drink this? Who drinks this? If you like sweet stuff, but you don't like really like super sweet, it's not seriously sweet. It's a lightly sweet taste. Well, delicious. And you guys know what that means. If the alcohol is gone, so am I. Thanks for watching me. I hope you guys have a great day. Check me out on YouTube. Follow me if you have not. This will be a replay over there if you want to watch it. Cool. If not, cool. You know, you're grown. I'm not going to tell you what to do with your life. Check me out. Follow me on Instagram. And I hope you guys have a very great day. Bye.